And welcome back into Coleman Today. I'm Debbie Wood, along with Jacqueline Schindel. She is here this morning representing the Better Business Bureau. And good morning to you. Good to see you.
Hey, Debbie.
Good to see you. Happy New Year. Absolutely. 2015.
I know.
Hard to believe, isn't it?
Wow, it just doesn't seem right. But it's here.
But it's here, isn't it?
Definitely here, yes.
Well, let's talk a little bit about the position that you have taken with the BBB. And, of course, they're so active in our community. Thanks to Ann Mullins all of these years.
Yes, Ann has been with the Better Business Bureau, I think, for 17 years, but she retired in the fall. I actually used to work with the Better Business Bureau many years ago and was sort of a salesperson at that time, part-time, and then I kind of quit and so forth. But when Ann's job positions came open, I sort of, you know, applied for that. And I'm not actually going to, she was like the regional vice president for the Coleman and Winston County area.
Okay.
And that's not really my title. My title is Member Engagement Representative.
All so right.
It sounds so impressive.
It does, doesn't it?
Now, if I can figure out what that is,
what that
I'll
means.
Be doing good.
Exactly. Yeah.
But basically, we are going to, we've kind of joined up with the Decatur Morgan County. And Tricia Pruitt is the actually vice president for that area. And so she has incorporated Coleman and Winston. And there also is a salesperson named Kathy Houston who is going to be approaching the different businesses in the community and seeing if they want to become an accredited business.
Okay.
So I'm sure they will see the businesses out there will see Kathy and they'll kind of like, okay, who is she? But,
right.
You know, she's kind of our new salesperson. But basically what I'm here for is to just try to work with the members and make sure that they are getting the most for their the big bang for their buck, whatever
right.
you want to call it, the most
exactly.
for their money. Because as a member, I want to make sure that they know that the BBB is just not this silent thing out there. There are a lot of things, and especially since I've been gone for
right.
several years, and I've come back into the fold, and I have done some training, and I realize, oh, we are so much more high tech than we ever were before.
Right.
So many different things that we offer our members, our accredited businesses.
Sure.
So I just want to make sure that people know I'm out there, and I'll probably come on periodically, sort of like Ann did, just
right.
to kind of let you know when there are scams and different issues
it happens,
and concerns.
It?
Oh, definitely.
And it's going on all the time, so that's great.
Yes. Right. Well, but what they did for me in the Huntsville office, and that is our main office, and that's where you need to call if you have a complaint.
Okay.
Whether you're a business or a consumer, Huntsville handles it. They have trained individuals that have done this for years. They know what they're doing.
Right.
I'm kind of on the periphery right here, and I hear about these scams, but I don't really know the procedure of what to do and how can we, you know, how can we go about helping with this. So please continue to call the Huntsville office for those calls.
Okay.
But I did get the top 10 scams of 2014.
Okay.
And if you'd like for me to, I can kind of go over those.
That'd be great.
Because they're still going on.
Sure.
But these were the ones that were identified as the top 10.
Okay.
And so I'm going to use my little cheat sheet here.
Absolutely.
The IRS impersonator phone calls. And these are people calling, pretending that they work with the Internal Revenue Service. And they're demanding money.
Mm-hmm.
And they're saying that maybe that you have a refund due or that you owe them. You
right.
know? So the scammers can sound threatening and will likely urge you to act immediately, trying to trick you into it. And you know, if you get a phone call from the IRS, yeah, that's the first thing you're gonna do is panic.
Sure.
Like, oh my gosh, did they not receive my check? You know,
right.
did they not get my money? What's the deal here?
What's going on?
And if they're being very aggressive about it, you might really fall for this.
Sure.
But basically what they're trying to do is they're trying to, of course, steal your identity.
Mm-hmm.
So they're going to ask you information, social security number, maybe even your bank account number.
And
this
they
kind
should
of
never
stuff.
Do that, right?
They should never.
Because if they're legitimate, they're going to have all that.
Exactly. And the IRS, if you owe them taxes, they're going to mail you a bill.
Mail.
They're not
going to
call you.
You,
okay? Mm-hmm. Now, they may follow up with a phone call, but you're going to get that bill first,
sure.
you know? So don't ever, ever, I mean, I can't stress that enough, just don't ever give out that information over the phone.
Right.
Okay? Government grant scams was another one, and the caller says that they are you're eligible now for a free government grant. And of course, then they want your checking account information so that they can put this money wired directly into your account, or or require that you send payment in order to claim the grant. First of all, did you even apply for the grant? If you didn't apply, how would the government know that you wanted one? You know, so that's kind of silly.
Right.
And you just don't ever, it just says that any official access point for all federal grant making agency is grants.gov. So you know what I'm saying? They're not going to call you and ask you for this information. Mm-hmm. The sweepstakes and lottery prize notification, and Ann probably talked about this in the past, but it's been reported by North Alabama residents that someone is calling that you have won a sweepstakes or a lottery. Okay, the caller who might claim to represent Publishers Clearinghouse or usually instructs the consumer to go to a local discount or department store or pharmacy and load money onto a reloadable debit or a card to cover the prize fees and taxes. Mailings sent to local residents typically come with a check that is made payable to the recipient for thousands of dollars, and it instructs you to cash the check and wire part of the funds back to them.
Wow.
And of course, you must remember that first of all, you have to enter to win, and if you have to pay anything for something you've won, then you haven't really won.
Exactly.
And you're not going to pay them the taxes, you're going to pay taxes to Uncle Sam.
Exactly.
So don't fall for that. I know everybody's out there, they want something for nothing, they're so excited about this.
But it doesn't happen.
It doesn't happen.
No way.
The grandparent scam, and this one was kind of tricky.
This has happened in our community.
Yeah. The grandparent receives a frantic phone call from someone that they say believes is their grandchild.
Right.
Okay. And the scam artist posing as their grandchild explains that he or she has gotten into trouble and needs their help. Mm-hmm. They either need money for because they have to post bond. They need thousands of dollars to post bond, or repairing the grandchild's car, or even covering lawyer fees, or even paying hospital bills for somebody else that they have injured. So your BBB advises you against disclosing any information before you've actually confirmed that this is your grandchild.
Yeah.
And that's just awful that
would
play on that.
I heard that this was happening last year in our community to military families. If you have a grandchild in the military, that they're calling and saying he can't come to the phone, he's in jail, you know, you need to wire this money. And I know of two different families that did that.
Oh.
And that's terrible. Number one, they're scared to death, you know, what's happening to our grandchild.
Right.
So, you know, as Ann always said, and I'm sure you will hear it more, if it sounds too good to be true, it is.
It is.
You know, so.
It is. And you know what? All you have to do is say, well, let me get your number. I'll call you right back.
Right.
Call the parents of the grandchild.
That's right.
Or call the grandchild if you have that. You know, call somebody that would really know.
Because
I know you'd hate to think that, oh, my grandchild really did need me and I didn't help them.
Exactly.
But let's verify it first before you just go give money to a stranger.
Mm-hmm.
The scams involving the reloadable debit cards. And the victims report the scam phone callers that make a variety of claims, including that you owe the IRS, you have a delinquent debt or an unpaid utility bill, or you've won a sweepstakes. And each of these scams, the caller often asks payment using a reloadable debit card, such as a Green Dot Money Pack card. I've heard of those. Available at many retailers. So it's easy to use, it's untraceable, and it's readily available, and it becomes a favorite among the scammers. And pretty much once you've bought this card, there's no refund. You can't get your money back. You purchased the card, that's a legitimate purchase, and then if you send it off
gone.
To the scammer, it's gone.
Yeah.
Counterfeit checks can be used in a variety of scams, including work-at-home opportunities, where the receiver is instructed to deposit a cashier's check and then wire money elsewhere. Until the financial institution can confirm the funds have finally been collected, the consumer is responsible for any funds he or she withdraws from that check deposit. So let's say you deposit a $1,000 check and then you send them $500. Guess what? You're out that $500, because then by the time the bank realizes that your check has not cleared, it's too late.
It's too late.
Bogus computer technicians. And these are computer technicians claiming to work for Microsoft or other computer companies. They're contacting consumers to notify them that their that their computer has operating problems, viruses, or other issues that need immediate attention. Mm-hmm. And they warn that these callers aim to gain remote access to your computer. They're not actually asking for money, but if you give them information so they can get into your mm-hmm. computer, then they have access. And if you have a bank account information or anything like that, they have access to it now.
Unreal.
Caller ID spoofing involves technology that allows you to alter the name and phone information that appears on the caller's ID boxes. And a lot of times companies were using this for people that worked at home, mm-hmm. so it made it look like they were at that business, particular business. So that's where it originally started.
Okay.
But now scam artists have found that the technology to be a great tool to trick consumers by masking their real number so that when they successfully scam someone out of their money or personal information, it'd be more difficult for the law enforcement agencies to track them down.
Wow.
So they're becoming so smart.
Smart.
You know, I keep thinking if they would just use their smarts, their intelligence, they could be millionaires.
Oh, absolutely.
They could
just
run
successful
companies without scamming people.
But you know, they're out there and they're doing this each and every day and working into the night to come up with other scams. And we just see it. We just see it all the time, don't we? Even in our community. Don't think for a minute that Coleman is...
Oh, no.
You know.
We're not totally safe. We have a great community here, but there are still people that,
absolutely.
From the outside, if nothing else, that come in.
Other countries.
Definitely the other countries. Okay, employment scams. While there are several variations of employment scams, some of the most common have been associated with secret shopping jobs and reshipping jobs that are advertised in the newspaper mm-hmm. and on websites like Craigslist, Monster.com, Career Builders, and Yahoo Hot Jobs. The job seeker is told that the employer is in a foreign country, red flag, mm-hmm. and needs an American contact to handle its business in the U.S. In some instances, the scammer fraudulently mm-hmm. disguises him or herself as being a representative of a reputable American company, and consumers should be wary of any employer that asks for your Social Security number, mm-hmm. bank account numbers, or money up front.
Absolutely.
And one more, the car wrap scam, okay? And I hadn't heard about this one.
I have not either.
But scammers place ads on the internet and send mass emails that claim that they will pay you to shrink wrap your car with their advertisement, and usually it's for an energy drink. Mm-hmm. And then the scammer promises to pay you a certain amount to rent the space on your car, but they send you a check for more than the amount. And then, of course, they tell you to deposit the check, take your share of the money, and wire the rest of it to the company that will wrap your car.
Wow.
Weeks after you wire the money, which could be thousands of dollars, you find out that the deposited check was fake.
Was fake.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. So you're out all that money.
Yeah.
And no car.
And no reason.
You're no wrapping.
Yes. And most of the times you just lose it. There's no way that the law enforcement can really do anything about it.
I was going to say, they probably can't trace it or track it.
A lot of
these
they cannot.
So I think these people probably have post office boxes sometimes.
Right.
And then they move. So just be so aware.
Yeah.
Now, I know Michael probably will put this on the screen, but let's give a number for Huntsville. That way, if somebody needs to call and have questions, whatever.
Don't know it.
Don't know it. Okay. All right.
Sorry.
That's nice and honest.
I think we do have it,
and Michael can put that on the screen.
Okay. And, sorry. I know there's a 1-800 number, and then there's a direct line.
That's right.
And sorry, right now, I don't know it.
Well, and that's okay. We'll get you that number. Like I said earlier, we'll probably have it on the screen, but that's the number that you need to call if you have any questions.
Yeah.
And we wish the best to you. It sounds like you're going to be very busy. And thanks for taking care of our community.
I'm hoping. I just want you to know that there is a presence. The Better Business Bureau is present here in Coleman County.
Yeah.
And if you do have questions or concerns, you know, you can call me or you can call the Huntsville office.
Absolutely. So, and I always love to go into a business that has the BBB on the door. You know, I belong because of real estate. And it's just, I think, an important thing. It says a lot about that character, that business.
Right.
So, all right. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks,
Debbie. And, of course, we'll be back with more right after this.